we're casting for season 2 currently. We're balling on the budget, so this is not a paid gig. But if you think you got half what the fuck a real bitch like Kinomi cat, shoot your motherfucking shot. Okay, slide in my DM, shoot me an email, let me know you're gonna be on season 2. There we go, see? I don't indulge in cat fights. Cause I'm a real ass bitch.
I may not be in the White House, but I'm commander in chief of this town.
Roses are red, violets are blue. You know who I am, but who are you?
In the A, they call me Anf. In Hollywood, I'm that nigga.
People know not to mess with Stoney. Unless they want me to set it off.
Rolling, so action.
Let's just start from the beginning, shall we? You've already watched this much, you idiots.
So I just picked up Wiz from the airport. I'm excited to see my man.
Wiz?
Oh, sorry. Davy pulled my Daviante type. We've been together about 4.5 years, 2 weeks, and 3 days.
Why do you call him Wiz?
I mean, I call him Wiz because I don't want you thirsty, dick sucking ass, fuck ass, dick riding hoes trying to come up on my man.
Is it because he doesn't want his face on TV? He doesn't want to be a part of production.
Right. He doesn't. Right, that too.
Or is he ashamed of you? Cut.
It's time to catch up with my man. You know, I ain't seen him in a little minute. And it's been too much drama popping off. And I gotta tell him what the fuck is going on.
Jesus, it's been so long since we've been out together.
This date is long overdue. Okay.
Actually, give me Kinomi. Curse with it.
Oh! I curse and everything!
Baby, thank you.
This motherfucking date is long the fuck overdue. So we're gonna see what he got the fuck to offer. Okay.
I got so much motherfucking gossip. Like, I feel like I haven't even been able to talk to him today. What the fuck has been going on?
You know, your man is like, when somebody tell you, keep a secret, and it's like, okay, I keep a secret, but I'm gonna tell my man. You know what I'm saying? So it's time to gossip with my bae.
I work all day with
you. I've been working, and I haven't even really been able to tell my motherfucking man what the fuck been going on.
Now, I know Kinomi wants to spend a little more time together, but work has been super busy lately. I'm just trying to make enough so I can provide for her.
I mean, you know, we live together, but it's like we don't really have time. We haven't had no us time. You know what I'm saying? Barely got no dick.
Now, you know Kinomi know I put it down, right? She faking for real, capping. As a matter of fact, cut that. We're not going to use that shit. Cut that right there. Don't use that one.
Damn, but I ain't going to hold you. Down. You know. What's the shit with the fries? Oh shit. Okay. Anyway,
Kino, did that just come out your cooch?
So you know what? Production, I think you trying me. You motherfuckers need to man your business when it comes to what the fuck I bring to the table. Literally. So, bitch has been trying it.
You pulled it out your cooch, though.
My purse is down there next to it. It wasn't.
Okay. So she says.
I'm just so over these bitches, like, You know what? Okay. I'm just eat your friend and that bitch found in her mouth.
5 minutes later.
Sorry. Sashi, motherfucking ass. You know, she pushed me in the koozie. Damn, it fucking drowned.
Yeah, I can't lie. I do get tired of hearing about all the drama in Kinomi's friend circle. It's always a bunch of mess and a bunch of bullshit.
Katie, snake ass, saved me. But at the same time, it's like, he a snake
fuck. Katie and Daviante are actually really close, surprisingly. Like, is that my man?
I
gotta
set my
edge
station up.
What happened?
So, anyway, in front of you at a party last night.
Yeah.
What the fuck is an Anfferny?
And when I say shit hit the motherfucker fan, baby.
That dude mama really named him Anfferny?
This hoe ass bitch acting out at the party last night.
I ain't gonna lie. KD read me the fuck down at the party, okay? He read me down. Like, it's not even funny. I don't know why I'm laughing.
He been talking shit, going back and forth with Sashi, and that's supposed to be my bitch.
And I understand because, okay, I snaked him, but at the same time, he was snaking me before I snaked him, so.
Bitch is acting motherfucking crazy. But you know what? I ain't gonna lie, I snaked his ass.
Now, see, KD, that's my boy. So I was surprised when I heard about all the drama and shit that went down between him and Kinomi.
He might be stuck dick, but that's not, that an excuse upon the fact that he's been snaking me before I started snaking his ass.
So we both been snaked.
Yeah, just both snakes.
In the grass.
So I know we fucked the truck.
KD and Kinomi was wrong for going to each other's personal nemesis and talking shit. That shit right there, that shit ain't cool.
And then, at the fucking party, he called himself reading everybody on some Nene League shit.
What?
Back. Yeah. Then, Stony Fat Ass, I done linked up with her nigga on some, you know, music shit, trying to get shit in order.
What would Daviante think of you as an amps relationship?
Davy Pooh supports everything that I do, so.
Does he know you said amp ate your pussy at his party? Didn't think so.
Well, I'll tell you. I'm just like over the shit. That's in the bag too. Fuck everybody. I'm over them. Over Anfferny. Over this fucking music shit. Fuck Katie dick sucking ass in that motherfucking project.
Hold on. I thought Katie was your boy, you know what I'm saying? Trying to help you with acting and music, all that.
So you know what you get with these big swole dumb niggas and they don't even motherfucking listen to you. Did he not hear what I said?
Yeah, this is a good opportunity for you.
Am I talking to a fucking wall? Hello?
He done snaked me.
But then you talk about him too as well, so.
Okay, he snagged me first.
Two wrongs don't make a right.
I feel like he's taking his side because he does have a relationship with him already, and it's just like, yo, you my nigga, I'm sucking your dick, like, fuck.
I don't know. I do want to do his project, but I don't know. I don't trust him. I don't trust them hoes. Anfferny ain't shit. I'm just over it.
Listen, that's your boy.
You know what? Maybe I could work with
him, though.
Exactly. He's right. He's right.
You know what I do?
Y'all know what to do. I fuck that pick a lane.
Yeah.
Okay, enough about them motherfuckers. It's time to talk about me and my man.
And?
You know what? Production, get him off the set.
And Tyrone.
Yeah, baby, so what else is known? Like, I feel like I haven't even really been able to, you know, vibe with you. I got no dick in a minute. You know what I'm saying? Like, are you not attracted to me anymore? I'm starting to get stressed out.
Bro, like, she's so dramatic.
I got stuff going on.
Stuff? I'm supposed to be getting fucking stuffed. Baby, we live together. I haven't been touched.
I get home, bills. I gotta pay bills, you know what I'm saying? I'm tired, you know what I'm saying? I come home, I work all day. What you expect?
I expect for you to come home and eat my pussy like it's catfish.
You know, catfish? Don't that mean it stinks?
I'm from Chicago. Catfish and spaghetti, stop fucking playing with me.
So it's good.
Yeah, oh my God.
I'm hurt. Like, I have all this stuff going on. And I just feel like you're not even there for me.
Here come Kinomi with them crocodile tears and shit. She know I'm the only one that's gonna listen to her.
You know I've always been by myself.
growing up in a foster care. Like, I've never had a mom.
I'm from the south side of Chicago. My mom raised me by herself. So,
you know, we head down at the welfare office once a week trying to get food stamps. The white bitch, we ringing my buzzer all the time. Going to Goodwill trying to get some socks. Having to steal chicken from Popeyes.
Kinomi, are you quoting Precious? Because you were raised by your mama.
Okay, sometimes I get carried away. I love Precious. Monique.
This, okay, cut.
Sorry.
I feel like you're not even connected.
I'm tired, like it's hard. I feel like a housewife with no ring. I cook, I clean, I pick up his motherfucking drawers, I wipe his PlayStation and shit off, I dust his shoes and stuff, and it's too much.
And I just love you so much. Pour my motherfucking heart out, Daviante.
Oh my gosh, bro.
I think I'm leaving.
She's so dramatic. Did I or did I not just say I love you?
What the fuck?
I'm gone. You can keep the pickles.
Nigga, what?
Kino.
No,
we filming.
No.
We filming.
Daviante fucking hurt, man. I'm tired.
Like.
So the other night things got completely out of hand at Ann's party, and kind of feel bad for reading them bitches down the way I did, but you know how I do.
Do you really feel bad?
No. Anyway, I have to get this group up. Excuse me before I was rudely interrupted. I gotta get this group of fucks together to get this production done, or else it's just gonna go to the wayside, and I can't have that. So, I'm making my calls.
Done, but I really would like to get you to come over and maybe we can discuss things. Hope to see you.
No one is answering. I just can't believe Kino would play me like this. Like, should you ever question me or my sexuality, you could have had the conversation with me. I don't know why you would go to a bitch I can't stand. Stony out of all people.
A long time no talk to. I know things were very hot the last time that we saw each other.
And at this point, it's not even about questioning my sexuality. There's worse things you can call me than that. But why would you go to my arch nemesis and throw me under the bus like that?
Definitely think we should talk.
I hate making this phone call to stone face and motherfucking Anfferny, but gotta do what I gotta do.
Hey, Stony. I just feel like it's time that we finally talk. So, you know, if maybe you and Anf could come over, there'll be booze and snacks. I know you'll enjoy that. So, yeah. Hope to see you. You know, just give me a call back. Let me know, okay? Thanks.
Hopefully they show up tonight. Bitches. None of these dumb fucks answer my phone calls. So, here I am on the roof. It's cold as shit. And I'm just praying and hoping that they show up. Here's our first guest, Miss Sashi.
Sashi, you showed up. Hey, girl.
Hey.
Can't.
Help yourself to these delectables. We're waiting for hopefully everyone else to show up. Good to see you.
Uh-huh.
Bitch.
Y'all, it's cold as hell on this roof.
You need to invest in more heat warmers?
You love to complain about my place and don't own your own.
Typical Sashi. Complaining about shit she can't even afford.
If I was living off my mama's checks, I would be living the same way.
You do live off your mama's check. It's your mama's house that you're in. But anyway.
Irrelevant.
This nigga KD hit us up. I guess he want to apologize for all the fuck shit that he been doing. So we'll see what this nigga got to say.
And here come my two favorite people, Stoney and Anne.
Hey, you guys. Good to see you.
I never did.
Them buns must be too tight on a nigga head. We ain't never hugged before. Like, what the fuck was he doing? And
the fuck?
Soon as me and Stoney get there, guess who there? Side shoe lane mask.
Dumb fucks.
I don't know why my girl Stoney and Amp the Roach is here, because I thought it was just gonna be me and Katie, but don't get me wrong, I love them.
Hope Kino show up, because I don't wanna be with these fucks.
Katie thirsty motherfucking ass has been blowing me the fuck up since the other night, and I'm just like, let's just relax. Like, I'm fucked down. So I show up to this dusty ass bullshit, just to see what the fuck you on it.
We're so excited to see Kinomi finally showed up, but then I think we both realized we were mad at each other. Fuck her.
Hey. No hugs?
No, thanks for having me.
Hey, great.
Then I see these fucking hoes. Excuse me?
What the fuck is this?
Like, the fuck are these thirm ass hoes at it?
I'm talking about these motherfuckers.
This Care Bear looking ass bimbo walking in here with a fake ass fur looking like Barney.
You told me she wasn't gonna be here.
I did. Okay. Okay. I pulled the soul food move.
We only showed up to see what this nigga had to talk about. But now that I see that this quack ass bitch is here, oh no, I'm ready to go. Give me a to go plate, but I'm ready to go.
Now enough is enough. Sit your asses down. We're going to work this out.
I'm fixing the plate.
Okay.
Excuse me, bitch. You've had enough to eat.
Kinomi is here. And this bright ass orange looking delicious.
You with Stoney, Amph.
Yeah, she was there too.
Hey, okay, guys.
You don't know stick stone, love. Hey,
you ain't gonna say nothing?
I'm trying.
Amph, why didn't you say anything when Kinomi disrespected your woman in front of you?
Oh no, she was just stating facts. She had ate before we got there.
Already, it's just too much bullshit. It's time to get things started.
Knife me.
Why didn't you get that shit when you first got up? He was about to get a knife.
We are here to make peace. Just knife me.
I'm gonna knife you, alright?
Right. Well, fork.
Y'all got forks.
The fuck you mean all we got is forks? There was a brand new pack of, what you call them, utensil things.
Clank, clank, clank.
There was knives in there.
Here he.
Or she.
Watch your fur.
Oh.
Wow, we're still taking shots, and are we?
Taking shots. Fucking production got us out of here in a motherfucking twister.
My chichis are starting to show through my shirt. I can't have Anth looking at me.
Why would you have a meeting
production
outside?
I'm glad I ain't had no wig on, cause you know that other bitch, I scared her little wig was gonna fall off.
Oh, thank God I had a sewing and not this dusty ass wig.
Excuse me. You're the ones who came 3 hours late. It was supposed to be daytime when we met.
You know me and Sappheiros. Let's get this shit going.
Okay. So I brought everyone together to get everything off their chest and get feelings out in the open.
All right, you guys. Clearly, we're in a ruckus. Nobody seems to like each other, but we all want to come together to do this production. And I'm not going to have y'all fuck my shit up, okay?
So what I wanted us to do was to write down our thoughts and feelings, say it out loud, put it into the fire. And let it go away forever. Oops.
Say what's on your chest or big ass titties and get it out of here. Okay?
We talking about
at least I got some. I guess anything is big to this nigga because he ain't never sucked on one before, but you know.
So, I'm going to give everybody pens and paper. Write your shit down.
What the fuck is this, kindergarten?
Right.
You guys have been acting like kindergartners.
Look who's fucking talking.
Whoa, right.
Who the details?
Damn, this is the first time I agreed with Quinoa on something. He looked like he came straight out of Sesame Street.
Oh, why don't we speak? You write it down.
Do I look like your fucking secretary?
Okay.
You no, because you ain't even got a job to have a secretary, so
whoa.
Shut the fuck up.
Whoa.
All
right,
too much. I'm sorry.
What is this? For this to be a peaceful meeting, Katie's coming in pretty damn hot.
Take one, pass it down.
You know, I knew this production wasn't shit, but I know Katie is my bitch. But I ain't gonna lie, this motherfucker production ain't gonna be shit. But Katie coming with these fucking crayons and paper. Excuse me?
Ready? You ain't got no. You didn't grab no napkins.
She's always demasculating. Or is it emasculating?
I don't know. Emasculating. That sounds like ejaculating.
Oh, sounds ready. Like. All right, now. Here's the thing.
Never mind.
What the fuck?
I'm over here just trying to enjoy my chicken, and all of a sudden, I hear something about ejaculating and masturbating.
I guess you can take a bitch off her knees, but a nigga can't fuck no sense into her.
Where's the class?
And they ain't talking about who masturbated, bitch!
I wanna let people speak their piece. When you have the... Man!
KD is giving me too much flamboyancy right now. I gotta rethink.
That nigga wrist game so strong with that thing because he be voguing all night, but you ain't heard that from me.
Sure turn this.
We could have just text whatever the fuck we about to write. Like, what?
I just want you guys to get everything out in the open.
Nigga, I can send a text. It is out in the open. I don't fuck with these niggas.
Y'all really doing this shit, huh? They really doing this paper stuff. I thought we were just gonna fake it and just like leave it there and throw it in the fire and say what we really had to say. I was just enjoying my chicken.
I know this scumbag did not take that chicken into that fire. I forgot broke people do act like that.
You know, Kinomi can't be nothing but a real ass bitch, okay? So I'm sitting there trying to think of the nicest shit I could say to these motherfuckers.
So much on my chest. What should I write down? What should I say? What should I not? Trying to keep the peace. But not really. Fuck them up.
I think this wind knocked us back into 1999. I feel like I'm in kindergarten again.
At least you were booking roles then.
Who would like to start first? Excuse me, no. They say it's not over till the fat lady sings, so you'll go last.
Okay.
Well, I'm about to be motherfucking Whitney Houston in this bitch, because I got a lot to say to these niggas.
I'll have a course. I got a lot to motherfucking say.
Of course, the most illiterate bitch at this table will want to go first.
Yeah, security might want to come on up here, because they know she'll get crazy.
Excuse me.
Nasty ass bitch.
It's time to get things started.
You gotta be a real bitch to do that.
Okay, excuse me. I'm trying to get out of here as quickly as possible.
To take those eyelashes off.
Yeah, I remember teachers in grammar school when the kids be talking and shit, wouldn't shut the fuck up and they'd be at the top of the class talking about, I'll wait. That's this. Because what the fuck?
Sony, I'll start with you. I'm sorry for calling you a pig nose bitch.
That's really good. I'm so proud of Kinomi.
Wait a minute, when she called me a pig nose bitch? Because I don't recall.
I think you called Sashi the pig nose bitch.
Oh, oops. Wrong bitch.
As I was saying before, I picked a fuck interrupted. I'm Spice Girl here.
Green Ranger.
What the fuck happened? Stoney, I know I called you a pig fat bitch. Do you fucking mind? And I know we've cleared the air. So, I'm sorry that I said those things.
Cleared the air? They cleared the air before Amp's party. A lot of shit went down after that. What is she talking about?
I just want to address that whatever you and your man are going through has nothing to do with you. And if Amp isn't satisfied in the bedroom because of size, then I have nothing to do with that. So I'm sorry you all are suffering.
And if you guys are suffering?
Well, I mean, I hold it down in the bedroom. Let's not get it twisted, but there's only so much I can hold down, and sometimes I gotta get up, but she just hold me down.
Okay. It's just an up and down thing.
It's more just like staying there. Okay.
Sasha, I'm sorry that you aren't best actress that you think you are. Sorry that you don't have any sauce like a real bitch. What did you say?
Light sauce.
Oh, it's chicken. Oh, okay.
Wrong sauce, Amph. Like, damn.
I'm sorry that I booked those roles over
you. Also, in trouble with a cute film.
Yeah, okay. Since when can you put home movies on your acting resume? Bitch, what?
It didn't make it to the theaters?
Now, you know that was straight to Pornhub.
Sorry that you didn't get it.
Y'all
seen
Hustle and Choke?
Honestly, I dodged a bullet not doing Hustle and Choke. If I wanted to make an OnlyFans movie, I could have took all of Kinomi's fans.
Maybe you should start wanting to get a check.
That's the last time. Hold on.
Okay.
Hold
cut, on. Cut.
KD?
Yes, doll.
I'm sorry that you're a watcher on the low, and I'm sorry that you snaked me.
See, this is why I'm gonna have to put my foot up Kinomi's ass. But I'm a changed person.
Are you really?
Yeah.
It's taken a lot of you not to swing on your motherfucking ass. Cause you were supposed to be my royal dog ass bitch. But I spare your motherfucking ass and cut you some slack. I'm sorry.
I can breathe.
You realize you didn't really apologize to anyone, right?
I did apologize.
You built them up to bring them down.
That's apologizing.
Oh.
And did you guys see how peaceful that was? It almost got physical.
But it did.
Right.
After listening to that second grade level reading bitch talk, finally my turn. I am an authentic person, but there's some things I hold on to, so I'm so glad I have this opportunity to read every motherfucking person at this table. Except for you, Stoney. You're my girl.
No, you just read her in the green screen.
Yeah.
Alright, I'll start with you, Katie.
But what is this? Gang up on KD Day? No, everybody can't have an issue with me. What have I done?
I'm sorry you're always under Quinoa's ass. Mm. Like she's gonna do something for you. You saw her two colors in your...
See what happens when you go against KD? God is on my side.
It's the devil and his diva ass trying to set you up.
This is so below my pay grade. Wind, you guys couldn't handle that?
I'm obviously the only real one at this...
Excuse the fuck out of me, because last time I checked, it was a real bitch right here, but guess somebody got me fucked up along the way.
And thank you for the segue, Kino.
Oh,
you know what? I think production planned all that haywire stuff going on. Of course, when it's my turn to talk, everything's flying out, hitting everybody. All the attention's not on me at this time. Oh. A couple more things should have hit Kinomi, though.
Production. What the fuck happened? Just dropping shit. Plates flying everywhere. The camera fell. Can't wait to get this ratchet stuff.
We're supposed to be nice. I love how Charlotte did her thing on your eyelashes. Charlotte
wet. Oh my god.
Get her, bitch.
Like, she did her thing.
I think I'll see the word babe.
My man is the fuck home. Speed this shit the fuck up, okay?
But I'm sorry that your life sucks so much, Kinoa.
But bitches ain't talking about throwing hands though. What's up?
Bitch, I don't have to put my hands on you because didn't you just end up in a pool? There's another one over there. Don't make me do it.
I have a fan. Right. Oh, so right. Always on 10.
Let's get
I'm over here chilling on two.
Second in a film.
Okay. So I was a simple bitch trying to talk like, girl, look at your sweater, bitch. Like, I'm sauced up, bitch. Come on, take that shit back to Rainbow, okay?
Where's your sweater from right now?
You know, my mom sent me this in the mail. I think it's from Ross.
I'm sorry that you can never be on my level. You just feel like you need to waste your energy on all this hate when I'm obviously here just chilling.
No worries.
You got lucky. You got a couple of rules. It's okay. Every artist has their season.
Okay, I think you got enough off your chest.
Right,
oh my god.
She read it, but
I don't think people understood the point of the exercise because no one was really apologizing for anything. We were taking jabs at one another. But it was pretty funny.
It's taking everything in me. Just fucking call it out really... looking like your nose.
Okay. Right, who's next?
I gotta give it to Sashi. Normally she ain't on her stuff, but yo, she read Kinomi.
I'll go with Anf. Ain't ready to step the fuck up.
Oh, I saw you in that movie Step Up. Look one of them chillers on the top, right?
Mm. Still got paid, unlike you. Alright.
He got me. I ain't got paid.
Kino, I'm sorry at Amp's party. I said that you should use your mustache and your sideburns to fix your edges. I should have said that you should have used the wolf pussy that was around your neck for your edges. It's not your fault you're bald headed on your edges.
It's not a fault.
Wolf pussy on my neck. I think you mean the wolf pussy on my vagina.
It's funny that she always missing a point when she stay having balls in her face. Nigga was talking about the fur around her neck, like.
You could use that hair too. Fumes are pretty thick.
Thank you.
That was such a great apology. Thank you for that.
Did you actually hear the apology?
No.
I've got my own.
He got his own vagina. He said the same
thing. He said right.
We all know what he got.
Got my own.
Excuse
vagina.
Me. I have the fan.
Amp has me fucked up.
Sashi, I'm sorry that I was going back and forth between you and Kino, and I'm sorry that I talked about your failed career as an actor. You were great when you were younger, but it's probably time to move on now. But you are still low.
I like that. That was nice.
Katie, you so fucking fake, bro. You just cast me as your lead, and you tell me to hang it up? Bitch, that just sounds like a hater.
Stung me.
Brick! Down the house.
I should not have called you a big bitch at Aunt's party. Mm-hmm. I don't hate you because you're fat. You're fat because I hate you.
Is this nigga quoting Mean Girls? It's that little fruity shit I be talking about.
How do you know what was said in Mean Girls?
Stoney be watching that shit.
Oh, okay.
Treat it!
Always quoting Mean Girls. Okay, girlfriend.
I'm quoting Mean Girls? It's one of the best movies ever made. What are you talking about? I mean, it's cool.
Love when you're on the same side. To Anf Frank.
Nigga,
sorry.
That's the best he came up
that
with.
You.
Corny ass shit. Right.
Sorry that you, Mr. ATL, have to live on the down low and is so worried about what is going on with my penis. Whoa. And what I'm doing with it, that you're worried about that.
Oh, I
please get a life
that.
Of your own.
Bitch, what not my man?
Thank you.
You can do what?
She can vouch for who? For what?
And why can't Kinomi vouch for you? Was it that old Anth in the studio?
I plead the fifth.
You're the one from the ATL, brother. We know how you guys get down. Love. Sorry that you are stuck with this brick house, Stoney. I know that makes you miserable. You wish you could get a bitch like Kino, but you can't.
He wasn't lying there. Amp's broke. Come on. Can't afford this pussy, baby. What?
And sorry that no one will hire you.
Yeah, that's kind of
awesome. Katie's right. Amp ain't shit.
Give me the fan. This shit would have spilled my yak.
And if it would have spilled it, he ain't buy shit. He can't afford shit.
I would have to beat your ass again like I did at the
you
pool.
You ain't do
party.
Shit. You threw a little wine like a little bitch. Yeah, but that's what they do in the Atlanta. That's what they do.
I'm
what
talking.
You doing?
Cool your little flaming ass off. Hold on.
Katie did not throw that carrot. He did not.
This bitch threw a carrot at me. In my face. This shit hurt.
Carrot kind of slipped. It wasn't supposed to have been thrown that hard. Oops.
Y'all got me all riled
sounds
up.
Sounds like you need to make apologies to your woman, but go ahead.
You know? No, not Katie. Sorry.
KD,
fuck
bitch.
KD? It stands for King David. I think she mean Queen David. I'm sorry. I feel like it was two females beside me.
I know Stoney paid for Amp to finish his GED this year, but there's three ladies at this table, and Katie would make four. You know what, Stoney girl, get your money back.
Look, we don't like each other, right? So, I don't even need to read what's on this paper to go ahead and tell you what I'm about to tell you. You bitch.
What?
I tried to cool you off that one time on the rooftop when I threw that little bit of wine in your face, but that seemed to excite you. Second of all, don't ever come for my fiance.
Fiance.
We good.
She's your fiance when you're not drinking White Claws, huh?
I don't recall no White Claws.
White Claws start hitting in there and start telling a bitch what's up.
I definitely got Hennessy in this cup tonight.
Pretty sure you have White Claws in the studio.
Tony, why you just sitting back so quiet?
Because I know how this nigga get when he be drinking his White Claws. And also a real ass bitch lets everybody else run their mouth. Then I'll address these hoes.
What I was gonna say was,
in the words of my bitch Mulatto, got the chopper singing like Aretha. I'll wait, cause it's Stony, bitch. I'ma kill him like the Grim Reaper.
Move the fuck on, cause you wanna be in my production.
First time ever Amp has a point, but it was because of me, of course. You're welcome.
Baby. It's been a time, you know?
Did you change your outfit in the middle of a scene?
No. I always had that yellow shirt on.
You know, we've been together for 7 years. Engaged 5.
And Stony is with the guy who proposed to her 5 years ago. And they're still not married. Hang it up. Flat screen.
I got a lot of shit going on, a lot of shit building up. We're about to really make some money, and that way I can get you everything that you really want in life. I'm really just trying to support you.
You can keep it between y'all.
Wow, we sure got some giggling ass bitches.
I need to know y'all's business.
Here come this mole ass Sashi. Always jumping in somebody's business. Just go back down in your little hole and just stay where you belong. You know what, I'm gonna stop, because I'm being good. I done threw my fire in for him. Yeah, I'm good.
Apparently what?
So y'all breaking up, Anfferny? Is that what you're saying?
I mean, what the fuck does nigga mean?
Why do you feel
the
need to put y'all's business out to some low-ass nigga?
Because he's
nasty-ass
bitch from Atlanta.
I'm talking about this bitch. What was saying something?
Okay, wait, no.
Because if he wanted to be a kid cat, then that's just what the fuck it is.
But you have Daviante.
Music to my ears when a bitch get caught up.
Please hand the fan over.
We're gonna make it work, all right?
Production, what was my tagline?
It was.
Oh, that's right. Because I'm about to set this bitch off. Light all they motherfucking asses up.
All right. You know what? Let's dead this right here. We'll talk about what we got going on at the house. But since you want to go and stick your little.
See, it's comments like this. Like, I'm trying to save and protect her relationship with Daviante, but she keeps making these type of comments. I don't get it. How does she know the size of his dick?
You having some issues?
No way.
You can't get it up on me. He might
not be attracted because I've never. But
hello, Daviante, what's it, Kelly?
Why you over here on this Insta Builder bitch over here with her little pumped up booty, her little inflated booty? Oh, you deflated it with, okay, yeah. That's cute.
I didn't tell her.
That's cute. And you know what? Next time you get a boob job, maybe go for a bigger cup, because what you're going with right now, it ain't really working for you. Okay?
I'm going to let you have it. I'm going to let you keep that.
Yeah.
Because, bitch, once we outside,
nigga, we is outside.
Oh, shit. It's all right. Once you from around this table, I'm going to tag that ass.
Anyway, it's okay.
Was that supposed to be your payback, Ann?
I missed. I ain't even gonna lie, I missed.
Y'all, I let y'all talk. Let the big bitch have the floor.
Okay, and that, is that the only thing you got is a big bitch?
That's because he be full.
Okay, I'm like your little scrawny man. Okay.
Definitely not. I ain't never seen that Wizard Kelly ass nigga. I guess he too ashamed his little builder bitch didn't come out right, so he don't want to be seen with her. Cause I don't know who that nigga is.
Where he at though? Cause we ain't seen him.
Don't worry about it.
Yeah, he doesn't want to be seen on camera either.
Yikes, bitch.
I guess he ain't real. His stick to gas. Bills is paid. Sis, you live in the cardboard box under the
let's get back on Stony.
And while we there, can we get some real Remy, not this, whatever you got.
This fake-ass Hawaiian Remy track from the dollar store that you done put up in your
baby, but it blends.
It's not blending.
I have to give it to Stony. She was going in. She read bitches down. Good job, girl.
And Katie, like, why you over here with your little fake ass dashiki looking thing thinking you from Africa, nigga? No, you a little too light skinned for that. Also, I don't know what production nigga you done fucked to get your little thing so that we come into your meeting here, but we'll let that go. And while we at it, I know you tried to have your little show with the Laugh Factory, nigga. Them people was paid, they told me. That was a Audience Unlimited paid gig that you had, sweetie. It's okay.
You told that bitch.
It might have slipped out.
I take my compliment back. Now she's rating me.
Can you handle the fire?
I can't, but I don't want to.
Bitch. And with your Brillo pad head ass, I can,
I know she ain't just come for Drew. Don't come for Drew. Drew ain't did nothing to nobody. Leave Drew alone. For Prince Drew. It's okay. She didn't mean it. She didn't mean it.
I can give you my stylist that can whip your head into shape because it's looking a little dry, baby.
Fire that ass.
Okay.
Did y'all get that number for the stylist? Because she didn't give it to me.
I got it.
You got it? Okay.
You need it today.
Baby, it's looking dry and lifeless. Okay. I'm a real ass, a rich ass bitch from the south. Guess it's over because a fat dude started to sing. Anyway, this was cute or whatever.
Started going on this rant, but what she needs to be doing is handling her man who told all her business at the studio. Let's get into that, shall we?
I don't know why you saying for anything at home, because he definitely told all your business at the studio, and she told me that.
Okay, well, that's fine.
Maybe y'all not even fucking.
This nigga always telling our business. I got his fucking ass when we get home. He ain't going to the studio with no build-a-bitch again.
Baby, what you worry about what's going on in your house or the lack thereof? Because apparently y'all ain't getting it on in the bedroom, okay, bitch. I guess that's why y'all so worried about what's going on with my dang-a-lang.
Want some KD dick. I don't want some KD dick. Baby, I'm not a man, okay? Baby.
Listen, I got a built like one.
Okay, baby, your little dick wouldn't do nothing for me anyway. What was you saying?
Damn, stop saying everything. I thought it was cold. Fuck. Hold on, I got a little tick too.
Well, that's
come on,
it's fucked up. I'm just saying what the fuck it is. I fucked your man.
Stay tuned.
Hey,
it's the build a bitch.